Hey, AJ.
Hey there.
You on by telephone?
Yeah, I'm just in my car.
You're on the go.
Yes. Crazy week. How are things with you?
Everything is pretty good, you know.
Good.
Good kind of good time of year.
Yep.
Survived another year, another winter.
I know. Feels like turning the page on winter.
Saw a lot of birds. I went for a walk this morning. Saw a lot of birds. I saw some red-winged blackbirds and some robins and some. Lots of birds were making a lot of noise. It looked like they were confident anyway, so it was a little catching, you know.
Yeah, that's right.
Hi guys, I'm back.
Yeah. Hey, okay.
So I did a little research on the capital planning. I don't know if I have time to talk about it, but one of the things was, have you looked at the bylaw ever or recently?
I looked at your email from just earlier this week, I think it was. Yeah. And I did skim that document. Yeah. That was useful.
Yeah. It's useful. It's still, you know, it's a lot of it's subject to town interpretation, but there's some good guidelines from the state and there's the bylaw itself. So.
Right.
Alan?
Everybody's there?
I see Mike.
I see Alan and Michael, yeah.
Nice.
Michael is in profile. Like
very definite profile. He's rather in the dark.
Witness protection.
Here comes Steve.
He's in the witness protection program, I think.
Yes.
That's the problem.
You all know what I look like. That's good enough. Remember me as I was.
don't talk like that, please, Michael. But you know, it's hard when you have lighting directly behind you.
I understand that, but
I have it too. But I have lights up there that I can shine down.
Yeah, well,
my big problem is during the day. This has to be closed if I'm going to do a Zoom because it's too much. There, now we can see a little bit.
Yeah, well, if I turn around a little or something like that, but you can see it's actually me. No, right.
That's really you.
That's good.
Yeah.
I trust everyone stayed healthy for the last little bit.
Yeah.
Except for Steve.
I finally got COVID about 2 weeks ago. But,
you did? No.
Yeah.
You avoided it all this time.
All this time, I thought I was in the clear, but it finally caught up with me. It was a very mild case, though. No,
thank goodness. How about your family? Did they get it too?
They didn't. I mean, they've all had it earlier, but
okay.
But no, I isolated and guest room for better part of 10 days, and yeah.
Wow.
So you have enhanced
the nuisance.
The main thing is you're healthy now.
Yes, totally fine.
Okay. Well, now that time out, I can get my glass of water. Now that everybody is here and it's 5:33, I call the meeting to order. And the first thing said, open the agenda. And I don't quite understand what that means, Becky. Because the next one says, review the agenda.
Now it should have been open the meeting.
Oh, thank you. I got very confused.
Sorry.
Oh, that's okay, hon. No problem. So we've opened the meeting. Has everybody had a chance to look at the agenda?
Yeah.
There's not much on it anyway. Okay, so then it's review the flooring. We have another bid on the flooring.
From Mercier.
Mercier, whatever. Out of West Springfield. We never did get a third one, did we? Because the company just never responded, never came out. What's the status, Becky, when she gets back?
I can hear. Sorry, I was just reaching for my folder.
That's okay.
So they, I reached out two or three times, and Matt had also, they didn't respond. Third one was solicited, but not received.
Not surprising. It does happen. They're just not interested and don't have the courtesy to tell us so, or they can't do it on our time frame. But, you know, you would think companies would be nice enough to say, I'm sorry, we're not interested or we can't do it, rather than just dangling. Okay, so what is the difference between the different kinds of tile? On the Mercier one, but between this and Summerlin.
Okay. Sorry, I didn't have my Summerlin quote out. Does everybody else have their Summerlin quote out? Anybody have it that wants to put it up online?
I'm looking at the Mercier, so.
Oh, sorry, I'm having to find it. Okay, here it is. Okay, this is Mannington was for kitchen. Okay, I have kitchen.
I know we had the kitchen. We had both of them from Summerlin.
Yeah, I'm just looking for, I found the kitchen from Summerlin. I'm looking for the
library.
And I think they might have quoted. See, the only, what confused me is the other quote I got. Anyway, it's the correct one. It is the library, even though it was mislabeled conference room. Maybe I did that. Okay, so I have both of the old quotes. So I can put those on screen and we'll put up. Should we look at the Summerlin and everybody has the other one, or do you want me to put up the Summerlin and the Mercier one?
Does everybody have the Mercier with them in front of them? I just printed it out just this minute, just before I came on. All right. If everybody has it, you may as well just put up Summerlin's.
Okay.
Sweet. Otherwise, it's going to get a little confusing.
Okay. Share this one. It's just now I print my son.
Yeah.
So there's the Summerlin.
The kitchen.
For the kitchen. And so Mercier for the kitchen was 12,000 or?
No, 16,810.
16,810 for the kitchen.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Very close. Well,
very close.
Sales tax, but it's only $900 more. But Summerlin is still lower.
Okay. Now, what about the library?
Kitchen.
Okay, before we go on to that.
Yeah,
I'm sorry.
I wanted to ask you a question. Was there some issue with disposal or something or other issue, like moving appliances or something that was
both of them say it has to be done by
okay, so that's apples,
where apples. Was it all furnishings, plumbing fixtures to be moved by others.
Okay.
And I Matt in his name is Matt, isn't it?
Yeah,
the custodian there. Yeah, Matt had indicated that he was going to need more help, and both Becky and I feel as though it's not up to the town to fund it. It's up to the school to fund it in their budget.
Okay, I just wanted to be clear that it was apples to apples, Ellen.
Yes, it is apples to apples.
Okay, thanks.
All right, and now we're gonna look at the library. Mm-hmm. I apologize. I think it says conference room, but it should say library. And it does say library right here. Yeah,
carpet for library mm-hmm. and one office. That must be library office.
Yeah.
Okay. Get to the bottom of that one.
Oh, that's a lot of difference.
Yeah, that's huge.
So now let's see if it's apples to apples or not.
Yeah, this doesn't have enough detail to be able to tell. That's one of the things I like about Summerlin. They give you detail, you know, this and this and this and this and this and so many feet and everything else.
Okay, so. So installation is 3,300, removals 22. So that's 5,620. Shipping and stuff. Freestyle to be determined.
Is that the color maybe, or?
It says Etic stock.
Yeah, that says for freestyle, but then it's also TBD, to be determined.
Right. That means the actual color.
Yeah, that's what I figured it was.
I think the other part of the Mercier is giving a number, a stock number or a code, so.
Yeah, J&J freestyle color FR5 or FRS47. And it sounds like that's gonna be in the entire thing.
Interesting.
Mm. Yeah, because this talks about on here a base, a 4-inch base, number 3. And he isn't saying, he's just saying, furnish and install new. Is it going to go, you know, he isn't telling us whether it's going to be a base, given the fact it's under it's on a concrete slab.
Oh, that's
not telling us what he's going to do.
That's the cool base. That's the kick edge that goes along the edge of the wall.
Oh, that's okay.
Thank you.
What in this thing would be under the flooring, if anything? I don't.
I assume they assume nothing. Just
nothing. It goes on the slab.
Yeah.
Yeah. But directly on the slab.
I believe so. They might put a sealer down, but that probably was done before. I mean, they've got to scrape all the adhesive off or remove it somehow.
Removal and disposal, carpet glue down. Yeah. So.
Mm-hmm.
They're spending $2,280 on doing that. So
I'm just going to pull up the other quote so we can look at it closer and see if all of these items are in the Mercer bid.
Oh, okay. You have more Mercer in more detail then.
No, I'm just.
No.
I don't think it says in it, but might as well.
Doesn't. Just gives us a number.
Well, that's kind of disconcerting in itself.
Yeah.
Is it? Okay, so for the library, we have like a $6,000 difference. And it says that they're going to take care of removal of existing, installation of new materials, disposal of materials.
Disposal of materials. But is that include, this is going to sound silly, the existing floor that they take up? Because it really, you know, they use materials for the installation of new materials and disposal of materials. Is that their leftover, their trash? Or is it also include what they take up? It's not really telling us.
I assume that because it says removal of existing floor coverings that it includes that.
Yeah, does it take, but disposal is the issue.
Yeah, well. I think I would assume so, but
I don't like to assume anything when we're dealing with companies.
I understand. Yeah.
unless they tell me something, I don't necessarily believe them.
Right. I'll be right back.
Enough. Pardon?
You'll be right back.
Oh, okay. You know, you worry about things like they could be mushy.
Sorry, dog emergency.
We understand.
Do you want me to, because I did push them to get it to us today. So are we good with accepting this dramatic difference, or should we ask for more detail?
Well,
I think we better ask for more detail.
Well, we could have a vote pending on the fact that it does include the disposal of the old rug.
Yeah, that might be easier given that we've got 15 minutes to do this or whatever it is.
Yeah. Okay. Then, of course, well, we don't vote for either. We just vote for, you know, a suggested amount, because she'll have to go out to bid again. And we'll have to go out to bid again anyway.
Right.
And then it's up to the FinCom, of course, you gentlemen on it, to find the money.
So are we ready for a motion on this?
Sure. I'm ready for a motion.
I move that we accept the Mercier Carpet Company bid to replace the flooring in the school. I recommend that from this committee.
So you recommend the cost of roughly $30,530. So if we say what? That's $30,035. If we could say, you know, what do we say? An amount not to exceed what?
How do we usually
want to get?
But do we say that we support the first of all, we support the flooring job at the school.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's get we make that a motion, Bob, please.
Okay.
Let's take it one step at a time.
Support the replacement of the flooring of the kitchen and the library. As a capital expense this year.
Do I have a second?
I'll second.
Is there any discussion?
I think that we could check on the details of make sure that Mercier is.
We have to.
Yeah.
Maybe we have a motion on the floor. Okay, I have a second. So let's run down and take a voice vote. McKay, yes.
Broad, aye.
Groves, aye.
Cashew, aye.
Sullivan, aye.
Okay, so it's unanimous that we recommend to the Finance Committee that this be in the capital plan for this year, for this coming year.
Yep.
But go ahead, Bob.
Good.
Were you saying something?
You weren't.
I definitely think we need more detail, though.
Yeah, I agree.
Go ahead.
I would say if, you know, assuming these are apples to apples comparison here, I think we should recommend, you know, funding this at an amount not to exceed whatever that is, roughly.
Well, let's add it up and then.
$30,530.
Yeah, $30,530. So do you want to take it to $31,000 just to make it round?
Yeah.
Because not to exceed takes care of that.
Right. Okay. Again, I think that's assuming there's no kind of compelling difference the proposed scope of work of both of these jobs.
I'd like to know what the color is, though. If you know what I mean, they just give us a code.
We don't get to decide that, do we?
Pardon? No. Okay.
Take a picture of the carpet in the library. Not in the conference room. Sorry. He took a picture of the carpet, and I think he was going to try to match what they had used in the
past. So the motion is not to exceed what amount?
$31,000.
$31,000.
Except I don't have it as a motion. We just decided the amount. So somebody make a motion, please.
Yeah, I'll make a motion to recommend funding the SES flooring project at an amount not to exceed $31,000.
Do I have a second?
I'll second that. Yeah.
Okay. Then let's go and let's do a voice vote.
Broad eye.
Groves eye.
Cashew eye.
Sullivan eye.
McKay eye. Okay. Very good. Now we get on to the next one, which is the John Deere. We now have a John Deere tractor in the mix, or John Deere backhoe in the mix, rather. And they sent us lots of paper. And it looks to me like that. Steve, did you have a chance to look at this to determine whether we're talking apples to apples again?
It is apples to apples to apples. And the John Deere fell right into the middle.
Okay. It's interesting that they're, as I recall, they're matching the aren't they, the 40,000 trade-in. Isn't that about what one of the other ones came, or was both of them came in?
The cat was 35,000 and the John Deere was 40. He was sure, the sales guy for John Deere, that he was going to be way under by offering 40,000, but nope.
Nope. I'm going to shut this off. I'm going to go mute because I've got a phone ringing.
Okay. So.
Okay. My husband picked it up, so now I can be back.
So okay. Just so I'm reading this correctly, we're looking at 141,200.
That's for John Deere, yes.
Yeah, okay.
Minus 40.
And minus the $40,000 trade-in.
No, that's 181.
No, that's
Oh, no, that's built into it. Yeah. Oh,
okay. Yes, it is.
I see, yep. It's 181,000 and then
200.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, got it. All right.
And what, just a quick review, what were the other ones?
I have my right folder. I filled the wrong folder.
Hard to believe that Caterpillar can't spell Caterpillar, but
right.
Never mind.
They spell it differently.
Okay.
That's the way they've gone to being cat.
Because I can't spell anything more than how many syllables? Four? Three?
Sorry, I was an English major, so.
That's okay. Is it really a spelling error, or is it the corporate got around certain things? I love it.
Sorry, the doorbell rang. I'll be right back.
Somebody wants to get in.
I think I have.
Yeah.
The new cat. I'm looking at a estimate that was 155,000.
Yeah,
I believe. Yeah,
exactly. That's what I got too.
Yeah. Is that what you have? Okay.
And there's also a trade-in though that.
Yeah, that would be before the $35,000. It was like 122 or 128.
Yeah, it was 120 something. Okay. After I don't have those papers. Okay. And that is which company?
Got
Milton?
Milton, yeah.
Caterpillar.
Another cat.
Tractor's a Caterpillar. The dealer, I think, was Southworth Milton, I think is what I'm looking at.
Could be.
Milton Cat, yeah, that's the...
Yeah.
My son-in-law happens to work for Caterpillar, so...
Got it.
Milton so Cat is the local... Matt and Milton Cat is the local, well, the sort of the regional
name,
the regional franchise, whatever.
So our other quotes, that were you guys able to put them all together? So we had the Caterpillar one.
I find a case. What date did the case come to us?
I have the case was.
Is that the original?
764.
I'm sorry, how much?
139,764.
With no trade.
And that was after the trade-in?
I don't believe they gave us a trade-in on this one.
Yeah, Case never gave a trade-in on, okay. on the...
No TI. Okay.
What was that number? Oh,
thank you very much.
39764.
139764.
We're good, and you'll have a new officer. Sorry.
And then the other one?
The other one, being the cat, I think is 155K before a trade-in. And I don't have the trade-in figure in front of me, but we think it's $35,000?
I think that's what Tim said, yes.
Yeah, it is $35,000.
So that takes $120,000. So that takes that down.
I'm sorry, so the cat was, sorry.
The cat's
the cat, we think, is 120K after
120K.
A 35K trade-in. Yeah. That's looking like the best.
Yep.
Well, the case doesn't include a trade-in, so we didn't.
We don't it. Know.
Yeah, well,
they weren't going to take it.
Right, they're not interested in it, right?
No. So it was no trade-in.
Yeah.
Okay, but we still have the backhoe has value.
Yes, exactly.
But not in the deal with Case.
Right, except we could auction it ourselves or something.
Well, that usually ends up worse.
I don't know.
It has.
Well, you never heard of Case eBay?
What?
Put it on eBay, Becky. Come on.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. Right. No.
No,
okay, so
probably a lot of people can use them after the weather in Shutesbury lately, you know?
Right. Okay, so we have, first of all, we need a motion to pass this on to the Finance Committee with a recommendation that we purchase it.
Right. So I'd like to make a motion to recommend purchase of a new cat backhoe loader.
You know, I think you have to leave the brand out of the vote.
Yeah.
Oh, you do?
You do.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Otherwise, that's too restrictive.
All right. So, let me start over. I'd like to make a motion that we recommend the purchase of a new backhoe loader at a cost not to exceed $120,000.
Beautiful.
Now the question is, do you want to add maybe 5,000, not you know, one of the not to exceed 125,000 in case there's something else that they need that they don't somehow I realize right now?
I don't think so. I mean, I think that's we have a quote in front of us.
Yeah. Well,
but okay. If you want to stick out, I almost feel comfortable with a little bit of a buffer. It doesn't mean we have to spend it. That's the thing. If it comes in at 120, it comes in at 120.
Steve, when you were talking with them, did they talk about any like annual price increases or anything that we have to be worried about the timing? If this is
no, that price increase did happen on January 1st.
Great.
It increased $28,000 from 2020 from that 12-hour period. It jumped $28,000 already.
Wow. Oh, my God. That's awful.
So if we wait until December 31st of 2023, we can watch it go up again.
There you go. Okay. What is the number we're talking about now?
120K.
So that's with the machine being 135 and, no, 150. With
155. And then a $35,000 trade-in.
Okay. Thank you. So you're voting for it. The question in the vote is whether...
Well, right now I want just a vote to recommend it to the Finance Committee. We'll do this in two steps. So so that everybody is clear on what's happening. So do I have a motion to recommend the purchase of a backhoe to the Finance Committee.
So moved. How's that?
Very good. Now I need a second.
Second.
Is there any discussion? Okay, roll call vote. Go ahead.
I just want to say, I see that our capital plan showed this for 2028. I've also talked to Tim about this machine, and I think that the machine we have has more good life in it. I know the argument against it, that it's got 7,000 hours, and that therefore it might very well run into some major mechanical issue. And I just have said before, and I won't repeat it, but that it's been well taken care of by our highway department. So the hours, which are on the bottom end of what is considered to be to trigger some kind of a major event in terms of repairs, we're at the bottom range of that 7,000 to 8,000 hours, I was told by Tim. But we have an exceptionally good history on this machine because it hasn't done heavy duty construction, and it's been well cared for by our highway department. And the operator has been mainly 95% of the time Tim Hunting, who's a very good operator and is careful with the machine. So I think we could hold on to it for a year or two. I know.
Hey, Bob, may I interrupt for a minute? The reason it was in 28 on the thing, as Becky explained it, I believe at the last meeting, is when she does up these charts, she assumes a 20-year life on everything that is appropriate. And so we're not at 20 years, but that doesn't mean it's not an appropriate purchase. Becky, am I correct with what you said at the last meeting?
Yeah, thank you. It depends on the individual machines and how it's being used.
Okay, well, anyway, that's what I have to say. So I would support putting this off.
Okay, so I need a motion, though, we did have a motion and a second.
That's his vote.
Okay. So I need a roll call vote. So somebody start. Bob already spoke. Either Michael, Steve, or AJ. Aye.
Cashew, aye.
Sullivan, aye.
Steve, did you say something? Two people came on at the same time. Okay, two people came on at the same time, and I just want to make sure it's clear. McKay, aye. So I believe the vote is 4-1.
One thing, and I think Steve's got to recuse himself from this vote. Just, I think that's the proper.
All right, I'll abstain from this one.
I think that's, I know I'm going to lose it, but.
Okay, then we're 3-1 and 1 abstention. Okay, we're 3 ayes, 1 nay, and 1 abstention. So it is going over to the FinCom. Thank you. Now we have something about the building committee. Do we have anything from them, Becky?
So we've been waiting, and I called the person we're waiting on. We're still waiting on getting the quotes, the final quotes. The issue is we were trying to figure out how much we were spending on the projects this year. We have $20,000 to take care of the projects we are currently working on, but when we complete them, there will be nothing left. So I think, in what we've done in the past on the building committee, when Bob was on it, would make a request when they were down on funds, when their projects had been complete, to make a $25,000 request. And I think that would be reasonable in this case as well.
Okay. So do I, is everybody clear on that?
I just want to ask a couple of questions, Becky, if I might.
Sure.
Now,
go ahead.
I'm a little confused because I know we have had transfers in the past to our revolving account for the building committee for building repair and maintenance, but we've also had it in the budget. So I'll just explain the differentiation there, because we have had a line where we've been supported by the budget for the building committee. And I think that we have had, maybe you're right, that we've had an instance, at least one, where we had a transfer from reserves. And so just explain that one to me, will you, please?
Becky, this is out over my head.
She froze, I think.
Oh.
I think she froze.
Oh, dear.
She's putting a grimace on.
Looks like she's thinking really hard, but yeah.
Then she shouldn't freeze. She should generate a lot of electrical energy.
To freeze.
She's got to reboot her computer, so she's going to take a minute.
Yeah. But you know when, when you want an answer is when it all of a sudden freezes.
So, while we're waiting, I'll throw a couple more things out there. The roof is in process for the school, but I just want to remind everybody again that that parking lot needs to be replaced. And yes. Tim, when he was plowing down by the lower parking area by the basketball court, tore up a good chunk of it this last storm. Ooh. And it's really not going to last much longer at all before the whole thing just falls apart. And I'm not quite sure why, but the highway department does not have a dedicated generator. So during the storm last week, we had to drag the stupid little construction generator out of the back room, fuel it up, plug it in just to get the garage doors open so we can get the trucks out to go plow. And then to top it off, our neighbors behind us, the Watkins, didn't have water because our well tank wouldn't fill back up because that's not on the line with our stupid little generator. So the highway department needs a dedicated generator, and I'm not sure why the buildings committee never installed one.
The buildings committee was never involved in any of the generators that were installed in town buildings.
Well, that explains that.
Yeah, and you're on the builders committee. but you know something, Steve, you know very well, it was a terrible year for plow because the ground wasn't frozen. So everything was really, really fragile under there. So that's too bad.
That has no bearing on a blacktop parking lot at the school.
Really? Well, how do you rip it up then?
Because it's alligator tracking, it's got big giant.
Whoa, gentlemen, please.
Oh, that's please. Becky's feedback.
One at a time, though.
That was Becky. No, she goes, she's going to be two Beckys to watch.
Right.
Yep, we're back to two. Now you can see the inside of my purse.
Mm-hmm. No, thank you.
I just want to point out that parking lot's coming up quick.
Yeah. Mm.
Thank you.
Well, okay.
Wasn't it on the budget years ago and then didn't get done? Or was it just funny? I'm sorry.
Oh, no, we don't.
No. Okay, Becky, there was a question that Bob asked. The difference between a line item and a...
I know the difference. I just wonder why, how we're funding it, whether we're funding it through the budget as we used to or through the capital process, and you know why, that's all.
It's always been a capital request, Bob.
Okay, maybe I guess I didn't remember it that way, but I could be wrong. So.
And it's a capital request, but it is, sorry. Can you still hear me?
I'd like to make a suggestion that we provide the town hall with better internet service somehow through our capital process.
Okay, so what is your question again, Bob?
I think my recollection was that we did fund that line for building the building committee through the budget process and not through capital. And you're saying that I'm mistaken. So that's your answer. That's my question.
It would always go through capital and then it ends up in the budget. Sometimes it would be a transfer from free cash or stabilization, and sometimes it's for a short while. I mean it shows up in the budget. I think for a while it was.
Whoa. No, she's still there.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, we can.
Yeah, sort of.
So the I'm looking at last year's budget, and through FY21, we had been funding a $5,000 every year through the budget.
Yeah, that's right.
And at this point, we have, but we hadn't been using it all. And at this point, we're using it all this year. And that's why we're asking for 20 more. And we're actually completing some of the projects, at least one of the projects was supposed to be done like 4 years ago, the window in the town clerk's office.
Right. That's a fairly minor expense. Anyway, the reason I asked that was because I did do some studying on the capital planning documents, the guidelines from the state, the town financial handbook, and also the bylaw. And they all say that we're supposed to get these requests in February by no later than February 1st. So that's another issue for me. So having these things come in the last minute, it's hard to do deliberation, do due diligence and deliberation on something when we haven't even known about it until the last minute. So I can't see us voting on this until I do a little homework about how this should be, what I think it should be funded, how it should be funded, maybe discuss at the finance committee. Because it needs to be funded. I'm not denying that. I'm saying, what's the problem?
Right, so let's just focus on the funding. We all know it's a brand new building committee. They are, you know, how quickly they can move and what they can get done is, you know, is all new information. So I think we want to do our best to support the ongoing maintenance of town buildings that they're working hard to institute. We had a door fall off last month. You know, we're trying to cope with, make sure that things function.
Okay. And thank you. Now, so what you're asking for, essentially figuring that they're going to run out of money, that we should recommend funding it at 20,000, and therefore they'll have enough work, they'll have money to work with next year.
Mm-hmm.
Correct?
Yeah.
Okay, so do I hear a motion to that effect?
I move
to recommend to the finance committee, et cetera.
I'll move that we recommend funding the building committee one way or the other, 20 grand for next fiscal year. For their
I'll second that.
Okay, so now that you've heard the motion and the second, is there any further discussion? Okay, hearing none, let's go down and do a roll call again.
Broad eye.
Groves eye.
Cashew eye.
Sullivan eye.
McKay eye. Okay, so you have a 5-0 vote. Thank you very much, gentlemen. Is there anything else to come before the committee? When are we going to meet with FinCom?
So April 4th, it's on the agenda.
Well, you are going to have to do it, one of you, because I'm in Aruba.
Okay.
Can we all come with you?
Yeah.
Everybody probably wants to after this last couple of weeks.
All right. So anyway. I think it's pretty straightforward year, I think. So
I know you all can. Actually, you can because you're chair of FinCom. But anyway. Right,
yeah.
But I know you gentlemen are absolutely competent to handle it.
Yeah. Yeah. Michael, Steve, if either of you are free on at 6:30 p.m. on April 4th, it'd be great if somebody else from the committee could join.
Great.
All right, great.
I thank you. And if there's nothing else to come before the committee, could we have a motion to adjourn?
I'll make a motion to adjourn.
Second.
Okay, is there any discussion? Well, there's no discussion. That's a motion that isn't handled. Okay, all those in favor, let's just hand it. It's easier. We don't have to ask for it. Okay, so we're all set. So everyone have a wonderful week. Please stay healthy.
Have a good time in Aruba.
Take care.
Oh, we will. It's one of my favorite places.
Thank you, everybody, for putting up with my on and offs.